Oh my god.
Mom.
You look like a ghost.
It's okay.
Why?
Mom, it's okay. It's okay.
No, Dad?
I'm sorry. Work. Well, he has to support his family. And pay alimony still, and the medical bills, and...
Understood. All those.
Bet you didn't expect this much guy energy today.
I do think this is a record number of mothers for one patient. Okay. I want everybody to understand nobody's on trial here. I just want to get a sense of the family.
Well, until recently, Alan lived with us.
She moved in with her father 18 months ago. Mm-hmm. We thought it might be good for her to heal that relationship. He's shown little interest in who Ellen really is. He's only interested in who he wants her to be.
Ellen is an artist. She's extremely bright and sensitive. She was never going to go into Chinese or computers or what have you.
Is that what you think your dad wants for you?
I don't know. I guess... I think he just wants me to be able to make a living.
Exactly. Is that a crime?
No crimes, remember?
The point is, Ellen's father never saw who she was. He left when she was very young.
Yeah, because you were sleeping with your best friend over there.
No, that's not why the marriage ended.
Oh, really? There's a better reason?
We are not here to defend our relationship.
When are you going to come up with a different narrative, Susan?
What really? Narrative?
What narrative, Susan?
No, this is the truth.
Jack didn't want to have sex.
Well, he likes it with me just fine, twice a week, like clockwork.
Oh, my God.
Besides, he's not the one who abandoned her.
We did not abandon Ellen. We moved to Phoenix.
They threw her out. They put her bags on the street.
Because we'd been dealing with Ellen's illness alone for years.
I didn't abandon my daughter. I love her more than life. I just didn't know what to do. I mean, she's dying right in front of us.
What's going on with you right now?
I'm sorry that I'm not a person anymore. I'm a problem. And it's all my fault.
Fuck fault. Fault and blame have no place here. Only how you want to live moving forward, who you want to be. How about you, Kelly? What do you think of all this?
I feel kind of angry, I guess. I just don't really get it, you know, just eat. I don't know, it's just like, it's not her life that she's just missing out on. It's my life too, you know, I don't get to have a sister. You know, I look at pictures of my prom and stuff, and all I think of is like, oh, that's when Ellen was in the hospital, or that's when she fainted on the bus.
Right.
And all of my friends, they think that she's some kind of freak. Like a freak who killed a girl.
Because of the blog.
Tumblr.
Yeah, and that's bad enough, but now people want to be like her and look like her and go through what she's going through.
Nobody died because of Ellen's artwork, okay? There's plenty of stuff out there for people to fetishize.
But that certainly didn't help to have notoriety for starting.
But that's what I'm saying. Ellen has talent.
I didn't say she doesn't.
But if you hadn't made her take her artwork away from her audience, she might have found her voice.
Ellen took it down herself after that young woman died because she knew it was the right thing to do.
You are so full of shit, Susan.
What?
Do you even hear what Judy is saying?
A young woman died.
No.
Meet me in the car.